This is the final stellation of the icosahedron, also known as the echidnahedron. Its resemblance to the echidna, one of the spikier members of the animal kingdom, gives the shape its nickname. Altogether, it has 180 faces, 92 vertices, and 270 edges. There are 60 sharp spiky vertices that come in groups of 5. 12 more vertices nestle between the groups of 5, and 20 more buried even deeper. The yellow vertices form a dodecahedron, the green ones an icosahedron, and the outer red ones an irregular truncated icosahedron, like a football or soccer ball. It can be constructed by taking an icosahedron and extending its faces until they meet again, so it's an icosahedron stellation. It's often called the final stellation, because it's the largest possible stellation. In each face plane, there are 9 triangles, 6 of one kind and 3 of another. However, there is another way to interpret this shape. If we fill in the gap between the 9 triangles, we get a single face, a 9-pointed star or enneagram, wrapping round the centre 4 times. Reassembling 20 of these gives us a shape that looks the same externally, but has extra structure inside. This is a subtle but crucial difference. Now there are just 20 of these enneagramic faces, all identical. The concave corners where edges meet are no longer counted as true vertices, so only the 60 identical spiky vertices remain. That makes this an example of a noble polyhedron, one of a small and beautiful family that are both isohedral and isogonal. I hope to explore these lesser-known shapes more fully in future. It's also very close to being a regular polyhedron. It has edges of 2 different lengths. If the vertices could be adjusted so that the faces became regular enneagrams, it would be regular, but this turns out to be impossible. The long edges are about 2% longer than the short edges, so it's fair to call this a near-miss regular polyhedron. Incidentally, although this version is still a stellation of the icosahedron, conventional rules prohibit hidden detail, so it doesn't appear on the official list. The dual is the great noble triangular hexacontahedron, with 60 identical isosceles triangles meeting at 20 identical vertices. Many of its properties could be predicted even before seeing it. An icosahedron stellation is built by extending the faces of an icosahedron outward, so its dual must be a dodecahedron with new faces stretched between its vertices. Here are the dodecahedron's vertices, with a single triangular face connecting 3 of them. This is called a faceted dodecahedron. And finally, because taking a dual swaps faces and vertices, the dual of a noble polyhedron is always noble itself. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.